Caravaggio, or, as the Italians would say, Caravaggio, was an Italian painter active around the beginning of the 17th century. He's famous for two main reasons: his amazing, often gory paintings with their great use of chiaroscuro, and his life story, which is best described as pretty bat-crap bonkers. Welcome to Art Review. This is David with the Head of Goliath. Painted sometime between 1605 and 1610 by Italian artist Michelangelo Merisi da Caravaggio, and then gifted to the Pope, because Caravaggio needed a favour from him. Namely, to be pardoned for maybe, probably, murdering a guy. And it probably,
maybe,
worked. As then he definitely,
probably,
wasn't murdered himself. Caravaggio was born in 1571 in Milan, where he began his training as a painter, before having to leave after getting into a fight with a police officer in 1592, and injuring him, or maybe killing him, whatever. He then relocated to Rome. Once in Rome, Caravaggio moved around quite a few different artist studios, but slowly started rising to prominence, and began to develop the style which he became synonymous with. A key element of that style was his dynamic use of the technique known as chiaroscuro, which literally translates to light-dark. Everything just sounds a little bit fancier in Italian. As the name suggests, it's all about the use of light sources, shadows, and the contrast between them. Originally developed by the Renaissance artists 100 years earlier, it was then expanded on by artists like Caravaggio during the art movement known as the Baroque, because you know what they say, if it ain't Baroque, don't fix it. This more extreme version of chiaroscuro exhibited by Caravaggio, where the areas between the light and the dark are very minimal, giving everything a very dramatic and dark appearance, is referred to as tenebrism, which translates to gloomyism. So again, you could see why they stick with the Italian version. The problem is, after moving to Rome, Caravaggio just kept on getting in trouble. He was known as a local hothead, getting in fights, duels, writing offensive poetry for which he could potentially have received a life sentence, throwing a plate of artichokes at a waiter, which I assume carries the same sentence in Italy, smearing poop on his landlady's door, maybe a little bit of pimping here and there, and generally being the sort of boy you wouldn't want your daughter to bring home. But he generally managed to avoid any serious jail time due to his wealthy and powerful connections. By 1600, Caravaggio was big news in Rome. His art was sought after and he was getting commissions left, right and centre. But that all changed on the 29th of May 1606, when he got in a fight with long-term enemy Ranuccio Tomassoni and fatally wounded him. Two of the leading theories as to why this happened are that it was a fight over a prostitute who Tomassoni pimped, and Caravaggio used as a model as well as probably as a prostitute, or it was over a game of tennis. We're not even entirely sure it was an intentional murder. Some theories suggest he may have just been trying to give Tomassoni a nice friendly castration and actually killed him by accident. Whatever happened, Caravaggio was in some deep trouble now that even he was struggled to squirm out of. He was sentenced to death despite not being present at the trial, and the entire population of Rome was under orders to behead him on sight, with the bounty to be paid if anyone could produce his severed head. So he left it. He went south to Naples. Smart move. These events may be the reason behind another thing you see in a lot of Caravaggio's work: decapitations. He certainly wasn't against the idea of a cheeky beheading before he had a bounty on his head, but from his death sentence in 1607 onwards, you do see what I think is fair to say is an above average amount of heads a bit further away from the shoulders than they should be in his work, culminating in this version of David with the Head of Goliath. Caravaggio actually modelled the severed head on himself. Yep, that's him there. And the holder of this head is identified as Little Caravaggio, widely thought to be referring to Cecco, his understudy and probably lover. He seems to have mixed feelings about the situation, which seems reasonable. Although there is an interesting alternate theory, where the Little Caravaggio is actually based on a young version of himself, showing how the acts of the younger years had led to the imminent demise of the adult Caravaggio. Deep. Caravaggio understandably wasn't overly happy about having a death sentence hanging over his head. He set about trying to get a pardon. This took him to Malta, where he tried to join a sacred order of knights. If he'd been successful, he would have received a full pardon for the murder, and he nearly was. But, Caravaggio being Caravaggio, he got into yet another fight. He was expelled from the order, put into a prison which was legendarily impossible to escape from, escaped from the inescapable prison, and then fled to Sicily before returning to Naples, where by this point pretty much everyone was trying to kill him for some reason or another, and he was generally about as popular in Italy as Hawaiian pizza. One night in the autumn of 1609, outside a Neapolitan tavern, Caravaggio was attacked by four men. He was left severely wounded, disfigured, and close to death. This was most likely an act of revenge by the Maltese Knights, but it may have been the Tomassoni family. If you don't know exactly which of the groups that's trying to kill you has attacked you, you know you've probably made some pretty poor decisions along the way. Caravaggio was running out of time and options, but he did still have one ace left up his sleeve. This painting. Apart from the pretty heavy symbolism, this painting had another very important purpose. It was sent to Pope Paul V's nephew, Scipione Borghese, a keen art collector who just happened to be in charge of papal pardons, in a wonderful union of two of Italy's favourite pastimes, great art and corruption. It sounds like it might have worked. In 1610, after 3 years on the run, a still gravely ill Caravaggio and a few more of his paintings, were on their way to Rome to accept his pardon. Unfortunately, whilst on this journey, Michelangelo Merisi da Caravaggio died just 38 years of age with a fever. There are many, many theories as to why. One of these includes suffering from sepsis from the injuries he was still recovering from. There's strong evidence that Caravaggio suffered from lead poisoning from his paint, which could have been fatal. Other theories include malaria, milk, or just good old-fashioned syphilis. Whatever did cause his untimely demise, Caravaggio is often considered to be a pivotal artist who played a big part in ushering in a new wave of artistic styling. And even though his rather erratic life choices led to a tragically short life, he created some of the most unique and recognisable art we have ever seen that still stands out today. It sounds like he had a lot of fun along the way. Thanks for watching as always. As some of my more observant viewers may have noticed, my once a month upload schedule has kind of fallen to the wayside. What can I say, I'm a busy guy. I'm going to try and continue to upload as often as I can, but they take a while, so it's going to be more of a case of when the video's ready, I'll get it up, rather than trying to rush one out every month. But thanks for all the support, thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.